Erik ten Hag's face like thunder sums up Man United misery as sack fears grow. Erik ten Hag's Manchester United hit a new low, with a thrashing at Crystal Palace which leaves the manager's future as Red Devils boss in doubt. Erik ten Hag stood on the touchline, with a face like thunder. These are the sort of performances and defeats that get managers the sack. And with his future already uncertain, it is impossible to see Ten Hag surviving. It is not even a season of mediocrity. It has become downright embarrassing. And just when you thought it could not get any worse, Manchester United hit a humiliating new low. They are now eighth in the table. This is Manchester United we are talking about. Once the greatest club in the world. And now languishing in mid-table, heading towards a season without European football. Man United twice tried to sign me. I turned them down as I was Arsenal through and through. Yes, they have been decimated with injuries, but there is no excuse for such bad defending. It was a betrayal of the shirt and the travelling fans. Where was the pride? Where was the passion? The debate has been raging over whether Sir Jim Ratcliffe should stick with Ten Hag, and yet this performance was the biggest argument for changing the manager, and Ten Hag's excuses about injuries should not wash. There was a collection of big-money players out on the pitch. Antony was £80 million. Rasmus Hojlund £73 million, and Casemiro has won 75 caps for Brazil. Yet none of them lived up to their reputations. United captain Bruno Fernandes was missing and, incredibly, it was the first game he has missed through injury in his entire club career. He is not everyone's idea of a leader, but they could have done with him out on the pitch. Casemiro battles with Ebereki Eze. Casemiro looked lost in the Manchester United defence. Instead, there was a ramshackle group of players who did not seem to even know what they were doing, as they were a disorganized mess with no idea of how to defend their goal. Crystal Palace winger Michael Aulis scored twice, tore United apart, and was easily the best player on the pitch. But the way United's defense just parted for him to run through and score his first goal was straight out of Sunday League. His second was world class. England boss Gareth Southgate sat in the stands, and he must be wondering what has happened to Kobbie Mainoo, who looked lost and unsure of his role in the team. At times, it looked like Mainoo was playing as a third centre-back in the makeshift defence made up of 36-year-old Johnny Evans and midfielder-turned-defender Casemiro, whose legs have gone. Palace just had too much energy and determination for United. Palace boss Oliver Glasner has instilled a new flair about his team, which underlines the difference a manager can make. Crystal Palace celebrate. Crystal Palace found life easy against Manchester United. Dutchman Ten Hag, meanwhile, seems intent on blaming everyone else for his own failings with a catalogue of excuses which cannot disguise the fact that United deserve better. Palace's first goal typified United's performance. Daniel Munoz took the throw-in. Aulis sent Casemiro sprawling to the floor with a lovely dummy before the United defense backed off. Aulis had time and space to pick his spot in the bottom corner. Aulis twice went close again before Casemiro's looping header went into the net, only for referee Jared Gillett to disallow it for a foul by Hojlund on Palace keeper Dean Henderson. Man United have definite interest in deal to sign Michael Aulis. Manchester United have a definite interest in Crystal Palace winger Michael Aulis. As TalkSport reporter Alex Crook provides an internal transfer update from Old Trafford, Erik ten Hag hopes that the arrival of minority shareholder Sir Jim Ratcliffe will provide him with a boost during the 2024 winter transfer window, as the Red Devils look to get their struggling campaign back on track. Aulis has attracted the attention of several Premier League giants during the 2023-24 season and could become the subject of a transfer saga before the market's February 1st deadline. Man United have endured a tumultuous season both on and off the pitch and hope that several astute signings will turn the focus back onto improving Ten Hag's chances of competing for trophies regularly. Man United a potential destination for Aulis during August 2023. Crystal Palace looked to have secured Aulis' long-term future at Selhurst Park after the winger penned a new deal. The 22-year-old snubbed Premier League giants Chelsea, who had activated his £35 million release clause in his old contract. Aulis would sign terms on a new four-year deal, dismissing any speculation over his immediate future, with Palace still reeling from the departure of Wilfried Zaha at the end of his contract in June 2023. However, the 2023/24 campaign has proved stop-start for the France U21 international, who suffered a severe hamstring injury last summer. The speedster would eventually make his return in a 3-2 home defeat to Everton in November 2023, but will miss the remainder of Palace's January fixtures after suffering another injury in the same area. But that setback hasn't turned Manchester United away from his services, who could be willing to part with one of their first-team players to secure Aulis' signature. According to the Daily Star, the Red Devils could offer former Palace defender Aaron Wan-Bissaka in a potential swap deal to lure the South London outfit into parting ways with Aulis. Palace have been credited with an interest in signing the fullback, with United prepared to lose the right-footed defender in a bid to secure the future of Aulis, the Eagles' wide man, described as unstoppable by TalkSport pundit Darren Bent, is thought to have a release clause in his contract, rumoured to be worth £60 million, which becomes active during the 2024 summer transfer window. Therefore, the Red Devils will be eager to secure Aulis' signature before his price tag shoots up in the coming months. Alex Crook transfer update on Michael Aulis. Crook believes that Ratcliffe could look to bide his time and change the profile of the team after several Hollywood signings have failed to work out in recent years. The TalkSport reporter claims there is definite interest in Aulis from Old Trafford. Crook told Givensport, "I think Man United have been there and done that in terms of Hollywood signing.